Good morning, how's everyone doing? It's been a while since I've been here. Where have all of you been?
At school.
Okay. Well, I was on vacation, but now I'm happy I'm back. I need a volunteer to come down and sit in the chair. Whoever wants to come and sit in the chair. Oakley?
Wait.
Now, I didn't tell you that when you sit in the chair, I'm going to put a blindfold on you. You're not going to be able to see a thing. Are you ready? Okay. So, I'm going to put it underneath your ponytail, and we'll put it over your eyes. Can you see anything?
No.
Nope, you can't see a thing. Okay. So, what Oakley is in right now is something called darkness. How many of you like being in a very dark room? Really? You like being in the dark? No one likes that, but some people like it. What happens when you're in a dark room? You can't
see
anything. And therefore, because you can't see anything, these start working really, really good, don't they? Because you start hearing a lot of things that probably aren't there. Like a little mouse running across the room. Or a door creaking. And some people say it must be a ghost. But it's not really a ghost. It's just the door creaking because the wind is blowing against it or something. But our ears become really attentive because we can't see. Well, you know, in the Old Testament lesson today, Isaiah is recounting for the people that they're living in darkness. They cannot see. Now, in Scripture, in the Bible, when God's talking about us not being able to see, He's talking about us not being able to see Him, or that we're spiritually blind. Although Oakley is not spiritually blind right now, she is blind. She can't see any of you, can she? So Oakley, what does it feel like not being able to see anything? Does it feel funny? Do you feel like you're all alone? That's what happens when we're in the darkness. And that's what Scripture relates to us, that we're actually alone. And because we're alone, Satan and the world has its way with us. We can do he and the world can do anything to us that they wish, because we're actually in the darkness. And therefore, since we can't see it in the way to go, we are subject to them. So now, Oakley, now that you're in the darkness, do you feel like you're all alone? You do feel like you're all alone when you're in darkness. But what does God say in our text today? Isaiah says, it is God who vindicates me. It's God who protects me. Even though Oakley is in darkness right now, she can't see anything, she knows that we're here. Because, Oakley, you can hear my voice, right? You know that I'm here. That way you know you're not alone. We as Christians, sometimes in this life, we will suffer many things and we'll feel like we're all alone. We'll feel like we're in the darkness, but are we really alone? Are we really in the darkness? No, because who is with us? Jesus is always with us. God has promised, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit have promised to always be with us. He tells us not to be afraid because I have given you eyes that can see. So therefore, Oakley, we're going to give you eyes that can see. And what do you see?
Kids.
You see all the kids, yeah. But I was hoping you would look up and see Jesus. Because when God opens our eyes, He opens our eyes and we can see Jesus. We can see Jesus. And this is God's work. He works this in us. He gives us spiritual eyes so that we can see Jesus. And He gives us spiritual ears so we can hear Jesus. And that's why it's important to be a Christian. Because a Christian will always look to Jesus for the forgiveness of their sins. And a Christian will always hear that their sins are forgiven because of what Jesus has done where? What did Jesus do for you? He went where? To take away all of your sins. Remember? Jesus went to the cross. Jesus went to the cross. And because He went to the cross, your sin is washed away, and He is giving you eyes to see and ears to hear. So with that, let's fold our hands and close our eyes, and let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank You for opening our eyes and our ears to the truth of Your Word. And help us always, O Lord, to look to You. For in You, O Lord, there is life and salvation. And help us, O Lord, to always listen to You and Your Word. For hearing Your word, You are building our faith. You are strengthening our faith. Lord Jesus, we pray that as we are hearing Your word today and as we are seeing You, that You always will be with us. For we know that it is You who vindicates us. It is You who has saved us. And it is You who is coming for us once again. Lord Jesus, we give You all thanks and praise, for You are the worthy one. And all the children said,
Amen.